the late 1300s, a plague struck Europe, killing approximately 25 million Europeans. This devastating event caused Europe's population to drop. However, after many years, Europe managed to survive, and this era became known as the Renaissance. The Renaissance is one of the most significant periods of history. It includes the development of trading cities, a rebirth in art and learning, causing many new ideas to appear. The ideas led to remarkable developments, such as the rise of humanism, new ways of thinking, and advances in many areas. Those ideas was developed from Italy to Northern Europe in many ways. There are obvious differences that can be seen when those ideas began to spread throughout the period of the Renaissance. Over time, the Renaissance had a wealthy trading cities and developed new ways of thinking, which led to a rebirth of arts and learning. Exploring overseas and other lands was a very important factor. It became very crucial to expanding their trade. Navigators and sailors explored overseas. They visited various lands, as well as acquiring resources from these lands. Renaissance sailors took spices to trade, such as peppercorn, nutmeg, and mace. They also traded with the East. They brought precious gems and silk to spark traders' interest. Trade with Asia was a great necessity towards Europe and other regions because of how vast of a land it is, the amount of resources they own, such as Asian spices. As trading economy increased, new ideas started to appear. People had renewed interest in the classical learning of ancient Greece and Rome, as well as an increase in desire for scientific and technical knowledge. The rise of famous painters had led to the rebirth of art. For example, Michelangelo was requested by people to paint the ceiling of the Sistine Chapel. As new ideas began to appear, many writers, philosophers, artists, and scholars discovered many factors that affected many regions. During the Renaissance, education became more important. Many scholars believed that education could be fully expressed only if people used their talents and abilities. As a result, classical studies were developed. The subjects are rhetoric, grammar, poetry, history, Latin, and Greek. These subjects came to be known as humanities, and the movement they inspired is known as humanism. Humanism had several significant features. It emphasized human dignity, beauty, and potential, and affected every aspect of culture in Europe, including philosophy, music, and arts. For example, humanists like Dante Alighieri created philosophical works, novels, dramas, and poems, which helped to the spread of humanism. Humanists, philosophers, and writers developed many ways to disseminate information. One of this is the development of paper out of rags and oils for ink. With this process, many people learned how to write. Writers and philosophers began creating books. For example, Northern philosopher Erasmus wrote extensively about the need for a pure and simple Christian life, and he advised his readers to educate children. His works were later displayed in Paris and condemned by the church. As people learned how to disseminate information, many writers began to develop cartography. Cartography is the study and practice of making maps. Map making involves the application of both scientific and artistic elements, combining graphic talents and specialized knowledge of compilation and design principles. Maps were at first printed using carved wooden blocks. Among the most important map makers of this period was Sebastian Munster. His works were published in 1540, which became the new global standard for maps of the world. Over time, art were also developed. The origins of Renaissance art can be traced to Italy in the late 13th and early 14th centuries. Renaissance artists had used idealized and symbolic representations of religious themes and the things they observed in nature. Artwork was created by anonymous artists who worked for the church. Many artists began creating three-dimensional objects, portraying shapes and textures accurately. painters began to paint and sculpt scenes from Greek and Roman myths to show an interest in classical learning and human nature. One of the most talented painters is Leonardo da Vinci. Two of his artworks are called The Last Supper and the Mona Lisa. These paintings continue to be studied and admired today. The Renaissance came about because of a change in the way of thinking. In an effort to learn, people began to want to understand the world around them. This study of the world and how it works was the start of a new age of science. Scientists developed ideas about nature. They began to claim that Earth was not the center of the universe. Many of the great scientific discoveries made during the Renaissance were in the area of astronomy. As the ideas in science continued to be developed, new discoveries were found and explored. The Renaissance was a period of reformation and art, so the knowledge of anatomy was crucial to artists. Andreas Vesalius is often called the father of anatomy. He dissected corpses for his work, and he was the first person to publish a manual for human anatomy with clear and detailed illustrations. The name of the manual he wrote on anatomy is called On the Structure of the Human Body. It was published in 1543. The unique approach taken by the artists allowed anatomy to be viewed in a completely new way for the first time. During the Renaissance, architects began to look back to the Romans and Greeks for inspiration when designing buildings. Much of Renaissance architecture style was taken from ancient Rome and Greece. Filippo Brunelleschi is widely considered the first Renaissance architect. Among his greatest accomplishments is the engineering of the Dome of Florence Cathedral. His cathedral took over 4 million bricks to construct. Like Roman domes, it is cut at the top with an opening and is surmounted by a lantern. The majority of Renaissance architecture were derived from ancient Greek and ancient Roman buildings. By the 1500s, the ideas of the Renaissance reached the growing cities in Northern Europe and Italy through trade, the movement of artists and scholars, and the development of the printing press. As cities grew, a vast trading network spread across Northern Europe. It was dominated by the Hanseatic League. Merchants traveling from place to place brought new ideas with them, and that eventually led to the spread of Renaissance ideas to Europe. In 15th century, Gutenberg invented the printing press. His invention of movable type printing made copying faster and cheaper, making them available to others. Printed books provided a quicker and easier exchange of ideas throughout Italy and helped spread the ideas of the Renaissance. Italy and Northern Europe adapted Renaissance ideas differently. Italian arts focused more on religion, which was Roman Catholicism. Their paintings reflected themes of humanism, classical mythology, and forms of ancient Greek artwork. While in Northern Europe, paintings showed scenes of everyday life and a more realistic view of humanity, which was very different from the mythological or religious scenes of Italian paintings. The Renaissance is one of the most significant periods of history. It was most known for its cultural and artistic achievements. The impact of these came from wealthy trading cities and new ideas of thinking, which led to the advances in many subjects like art, science, engineering, and literature. These ideas could not have been prosperous without the spread through trade, traveling artists, and the invention of the printing press throughout Europe and Italy. The Renaissance lives today as a fire that has burned its way through time and is now lighting the path ahead for humanity of the 21st century. I got bribes in Atlanta, just at the V in the family, credit cards in the scammers, hitting the licks in the family, legacies, family.